Hey guys, Dean Eccles here. Thanks for tuning in to another great episode. I have another how-to here on it's actually an update to a video I did a couple years back. A couple years back, my kids and I, we realized that with our two-wheel drive Stampedes, we were kind of rough on them, and we needed some obstacles that we could use kind of like Monster Jam, or vehicles, or obstacles that we can use out in the field to use like markers, or just go out and do like some RC bowling with. And so we took some 2 liters. It's a one right here. Actually, yep, here's another one. Here's one that I found in my garage that we had did, but we never really used too much. As you can see, these have taken a beating. Now originally we used high-vis spray-on paint on the 2 liters after we cleaned them up, and we never clear coated them or anything. The problem with these is that over time the paint starts to flake off whether you're out there in the field, and that's not good for the environment. Not only that, it flakes off in your car, gets all over, and then if you have a significant other, you know, they tend to get upset when they see like paint flakes all over the place. So not only that, they just take a beating and they need some new ones. So what we did was, let's get rid of these. Oops. I don't know if I had anything down there that's breakable. I hope not. So what I did was, I took these 2 liters, cleaned them up. Now, I didn't clean them up entirely perfect or anything like that. So what I did was, I took all the advertising wrapper and whatnot on there, cleaned it up really good. I didn't make it perfect. If you're looking to make it perfect and you're kind of like anal about having it look perfect, what you can do is there's different types of glue removers that you could use to pull off the glue for the advertisements that are stuck on here. And then after that's dried and washed off, go ahead and take some rubbing alcohol and go ahead and rub the alcohol all over it. And what that does is that will get the minerals and the chemicals that are soaked up from the glue remover into the actual plastic, so that way you can airbrush. What I did was I went ahead and airbrushed these, and as you can see, these are kind of bright colored. Now originally, well, I already threw them down there. Originally I did not back them with white before I sprayed the spray on orange. So this time I went ahead and did, I sprayed the orange, or before I sprayed the orange, my bad. I used opaque Createx airbrush white paint so that they were all white. They're not exactly perfect. I still got some white at the top. No big deal. We're just going to turn them up anyway. And then I did fluorescent Createx orange over that. Took one solid coat of white, actually two to three coats of white, and then I laid down the fluorescent orange. And on this one, I used just basic opaque yellow because my local hobby shops were out of the fluorescent yellow. And then after I did about 3 or 4 coats of that on them, I went ahead and clear coated them. And as you can see, I think they work pretty good. Looks pretty cool. I'm hoping that these are going to hold up a lot more. These shouldn't flake as much. If somebody's got an idea out there on how to make them better, let me know. I tried the paint on the inside, and what we like to do is we put sand in these because these are lightweight, so with the wind it blows, man. You know, I live along the Mississippi River and it's extremely windy where I'm at times. So let's move over here. This, gotta be careful, man, my hand's still recovering from surgery. This is a huge bag of sand. Yes, we went last year or a couple years ago and bought a bag of sand. And what we do is we take our funnel that's right here, move it back, take the top off, funnel inside, and we add about, actually that's a little funnel, but that's the only one I can find at the time. You know, the kids always playing in the dirt and stuff like that. Who knows what they do with stuff. This is the only one I can find, so I may have to talk to kids about that. You take your funnel, put it on there, and then you take your cup. I figured I'd grab the first kid's cup I could use because nothing is better at working than minions. So I grabbed the minion cup. You scoop up some sand, put it in there. It takes about an actual one or two, not full cups, but actual measuring cups of sand in here just to weigh it down. You could add more if you want. You could add rocks if you want. We try not to add rocks and stuff like that because we have different type of RCs that hit these, and some of them have broken in the past because we put too much in there. So we strictly use the sand, and about one or two cups of sand, they stay in place, and then they're easy to transport and they should not flake, and they're high vis out there in the field. Alright guys, this is just kind of what I do. Some of you guys might have some ideas on how to improve it. You are more than welcome to go ahead and comment and post a link, or not a link, but your tip how to make them better. You may use them in different ways. Feel free. So, okay guys, thanks for tuning in. Much appreciated. Thrash it, bash it, break it. No regrets.